Chapter 1, Intro. Hello and welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Martin, your friendly smart home tinkerer who enjoys pushing automations just a little too far, so you don't have to. Today, we're taking a close look at the eMotion Pro Presence Sensor from LinknLink. I'll walk you through unboxing, setup, and integration with Home Assistant. Plus, I'll share what I think after testing it out in my own home. Chapter 2, Disclaimer. As always, a quick word before we start. This isn't a paid promotion. LinknLink kindly sent me the sensor so I could put it through its paces, but there's no script, no sponsorship, no money changing hands, and no obligations attached. So everything you'll see and hear today is based entirely on my own testing and genuine impression. Chapter 3, What's in the Box? Let's start with the unboxing. Inside the package, you'll find the eMotion Pro sensor, which feels solid and well put together. A wall mount bracket slash stand, which unfortunately feels a bit weak and flimsy. A USB-A to USB-C power cable. And a multilingual quick start guide. Yes, including English. That is pretty much everything you need to get started. Simple, compact, and ready to go. And to give you a quick snapshot, here are the main specifications from LinknLink. They'll help you see how the eMotion Pro compares with their other models. Chapter 4, Setup. Before the sensor can talk to Home Assistant, we need to get it up and running with the LinknLink mobile app. That's also where firmware updates are handled, so don't skip this step. Step 1. LinknLink App. If you'd like a complete walkthrough of the LinknLink App installation, I've already covered it in detail in my review of the eMotion Max sensor. You can find that video linked in the top right corner or down in the description. LinknLink Wi-Fi eMotion Max Plus THS cable. Setup and full review. Presence detection in Home Assistant. Step 2. eMotion Pro Presence Sensor. The eMotion Pro is designed primarily for presence detection. Using advanced 24 GHz millimeter wave radar, it can monitor up to 4 independent zones with impressive accuracy. It also includes long-range infrared emitters for appliance control up to 15 meter, and a built-in brightness sensor to measure ambient light. The eMotion Pro connects directly to your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network. The Motion2MQTT service acts as a bridge, linking the sensor to Home Assistant via MQTT. Once set up, everything works fully locally in Home Assistant. Now let's get it installed. Here is a step-by-step guide on how to install the eMotion Pro in the LinknLink app. Power on the eMotion Pro. And check that the indicator light flashes blue. Open the LinknLink app on your phone. Tap the plus in the top right corner and select Add Device. Choose Add a New Device. Select E-Series Hubs and Sensors. From the list, choose the correct device, eMotion Pro. Tap Next. Make sure your phone's Bluetooth is enabled, then tap Done. Select your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network, enter the password, and tap Connect Now. The LED will slow down, then turn off. This means the device has successfully connected. Select a room, and tap Next. Give your device a name, and save. That's it. Tap Use Device Now to finish setup. Before moving on, check for the latest firmware. Open your newly added eMotion Pro in the app. If a found new firmware pop-up appears, tap Update Now. If you see a sub-device detection pop-up instead, simply cancel. We'll add those in a moment. Tap the three dots in the top right corner and select Settings. Go to Firmware Update and follow the prompts. Now your eMotion Pro is up to date. To unlock all features, we need to add the sub-devices. Open your eMotion Pro sensor in the app. When prompted, tap Add Now to install the first sub-device. Assign it to a room, tap Next, name the device, and save. Adjust the device and zone names if needed, then save again. Tap I Know It. The first sub-device present sensor is now active. Tap Use Device Now. Next, scroll down to configure your zones. Adjust the detection range, colors, and other settings as needed. Tap Save in the top right corner. Repeat this process for all four zones. To add the next sub-device, return to your main eMotion Pro device. Tap Add Now again. Select the room. Tap Next. Give the device a name and save. Tap I Know It. Then use Device Now. The second sub-device, the brightness sensor, is now installed. The last feature is infrared control. Even though it is built into the eMotion Pro, LinknLink treats it as a separate unit. That means you need to add it to the system as if it were a new device. Tap the plus in the top right corner. Select Add Device, then Remote Controls, and tap on IR and RF devices. Choose your eMotion Pro sensor. Select the device you want to control, and choose the top option Add for HA, then tap Next. Choose the brand and model. Test the IR commands until one works. Then tap Works Well. Tap Continue. Assign the device to a room. Tap Next. Give it a name and save. Tap I Know It. Then use Device Now. Step 3, MQTT connection. Setting up MQTT is quick and easy. I've already shown the full process step by step in my eMotion Max review, so I won't repeat it here. If you need help, check out that video. LinknLink Wi-Fi eMotion Max Plus THS cable setup and full review. Presence detection in Home Assistant. You'll find the link in the top right corner or in the description below. Step 4. Home Assistant. Now let's bring the eMotion Pro into Home Assistant. It should show up under the same name you used in the LinknLink app. Open Home Assistant settings. Go to Devices and Services. Select Devices from the top menu. Find your LinknLink device and open it. Since I used the default names earlier, I'll now give the device a proper name here. To edit the device's properties, click the pencil icon in the top right corner. In the dialog box, set a new name. Assign the device to a room and add labels if you want to keep things organized. Click Update to apply changes. Need help naming your devices? Check out my video. The perfect naming conventions simplify your smart home. You'll find the link in the top right corner or in the description below. Chapter 5. Validation. On paper, the eMotion Pro promises to be a powerful and compact presence sensor, but specification doesn't always tell the whole story. Now it's time to put it to the test and see how it performs in a real-world setup. To make monitoring easier, I've temporarily added the most important eMotion Pro entities to my Home Assistant dashboard. This way, we can clearly track what the sensor is detecting. I've skipped the configuration entities. They're useful behind the scenes, but not necessary for validation. And just to clarify, this validation is being done entirely within Home Assistant. You'll see the LinknLink app on my phone screen occasionally, but that's only so I can share a bit of extra information with you. I'm not testing the app itself, nor any phone-related features. Test 1. Presence Detection. The eMotion Pro doesn't expose as many entities as the eMotion Max, but it is still quite impressive, and most importantly, it works. It reliably detects a person, shows the distance from the sensor, and identifies which zone the person is in. One key difference compared to the eMotion Max is how zones are handled. Here, zones are defined strictly by distance from the sensor, whereas the eMotion Max allows you to configure custom zones. Test 2. Brightness. To check brightness accuracy, I pulled out my trusty Seekonik Flashmate L308X, the same light meter I use for landscape photography. Here is a quick comparison. Living room at sunset. The eMotion Pro reads 102 to 110 lux, while the light meter shows 100 to 110 lux. As you can see, the readings are very close, which makes the brightness sensor quite reliable for smart home automations. Test 3. Infrared control. Unfortunately, I couldn't properly test this feature. None of my TVs use infrared remotes, they all rely on Bluetooth instead. However, I was able to confirm that the infrared blaster from the eMotion Pro can be exposed to Home Assistant, which wasn't possible with the eMotion Max. That's already a nice improvement for those who still use IR-based appliances. Chapter 6. The verdict. Just like with the eMotion Max, this is my very first time using the eMotion Pro. I'll be keeping it in daily use, and in about 6 months, I'll share an update on how it performs over the long term. Part 1. Where it falls short. Wall mount / stand. This hasn't changed since the eMotion Max. The mount is still the weakest part of the package. It feels flimsy, can't be screwed into the wall, and relies entirely on sticky tape. I wouldn't trust it for long-term use. Wi-Fi only. The sensor connects over Wi-Fi, which works fine, but personally, I prefer Zigbee, Z-Wave, or Matter for devices that run 24/7. Another app to install. Yes, the app is good, but I'd rather not have to install yet another one just for setup. A web-based option or fully local pairing would be much cleaner. Part 2. What impressed me? Build quality. The eMotion Pro makes a great first impression. It feels sturdy, well-made, and has the sort of finish you'd normally expect from higher-end gear. Presence detection. The core feature works exactly as it should. It can tell when someone is in the room and track their distance from the sensor. That might sound simple, but in practice it's incredibly powerful for automation. Light sensor. This was a pleasant surprise. Having a brightness sensor built into the same device means you can create smarter automations. Infrared blaster. Unlike the eMotion Max, the eMotion Pro fully integrates this feature with Home Assistant, unlocking a range of exciting automation possibilities. The LinknLink App. The companion app is refreshingly easy to use. Setup takes just a few taps, and pairing new devices is quick and hassle-free. MQTT integration. This is where the device really shines. With MQTT, the eMotion Pro talks to Home Assistant reliably, and once you've set it up, it runs quietly in the background without needing extra attention. THS cable. Swapping the standard USB power lead for the THS cable gives you temperature and humidity readings as well. It's a simple add-on, but it really boosts the sensor's usefulness. Price. Considering its performance, the eMotion Pro is surprisingly affordable. It costs less than comparable sensors from bigger names, yet matches them in functionality. Discount. And for anyone interested, there's a limited time 15% discount code for the eMotion Pro on the official LinknLink site. You'll find all the details in the description below. Thanks again to LinknLink for making that possible. Part 3. News from LinknLink. For anyone who missed my eMotion Max review, here are the updates from LinknLink's side. The newest sensor, the eMotion Ultra, now ships with a proper magnetic wall mount. Future models are expected to include Matter and Samsung SmartThings support. Part 4. Final take. So, is the eMotion Pro worth it? Yes, without a doubt. It is affordable, accurate, and well-built, with enough features to cover most smart home scenarios. Sure, it's not perfect. The mount is poor and Wi-Fi might not be ideal for everyone, but overall, it is one of the best value presence sensors I've tested so far. And honestly, I'm excited for what's next. If LinknLink can deliver the same performance with Matter support in a future release, this could become one of the best value for money presence sensors on the market. Chapter 7. Thank you. And that's a wrap on the eMotion Pro adventure. From unboxing chaos to setup triumphs and real-world tests. If this guide helped you get things working, gave you a clever automation idea, or just spared you some frustration, hit that like button, leave a comment, or share it with a fellow smart home enthusiast. Every little click helps the channel grow. Feeling extra generous? You can support my antics and tutorials via Buy Me a Coffee or PayPal. Links are in the description. Your support keeps the lights blinking, sensors pinging, and videos coming. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep automating, stay curious, and happy detecting.